I'm Sonal Kalra, and this comes to you from Hindustan Times. On 2nd October this year, we are celebrating the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. We're looking at various facets of his life, including cinematic adaptation. And when you talk about cinema and Mahatma Gandhi, the first thing that comes to your mind is Sir Richard Attenborough's landmark film, Gandhi. Today, we are very privileged and honored to have with us Rohini Hattangadi, the National Award-winning and BAFTA Award-winning actress, who beautifully portrayed the role of Mahatma Gandhi's wife, Kasturba. Let's talk to her and revisit some memories. To begin with, I want to know that a girl, a young girl from National School of Drama, who's more interested in theatre than cinema,
yes,
gets a call from none other than Richard Attenborough. And he wants her to play a character which is much older than her age. Yes. What was your first reaction?
Well, my first reaction was, I have to play a role. In the beginning, I didn't know, very naive of me, but I didn't know the whole gamut of this film.
The scale
of the film. And for me, it was just a role. We had a first meeting in the Centaur Hotel. I was called by Dolly Thakur. She was Liza, kind of thing. And that time I told him that this is my fourth film and this will be my fourth film I have. But I am from theatre. So the conversation was all from theatre.
Right.
And no mention of film. Then the next day, Dolly, again, that time I didn't have even a phone. She wired me saying, please contact me. So I went to my grocer and called her. And she said, you have been selected to go to England for a screen test.
Okay.
And that was just 8 days. I didn't have passport.
Oh, God.
She said, we'll do something. So she came down with me. I had a 6 months passport, temporary passport. And we were given a scene to do. So I had the scene. I had prepared everything, right from my bindi till my bangles and Mangal Sutra and everything. Because that scene was in South Africa, where she refuses to clean latrine. So I was fully prepared, like in theater. I mean, that discipline, that it helped me a lot. I went there, did the screen test with Ben, because they had paired us.
I see.
Ben, myself, Nasruddin Shah and Smita Patil, and John Hurt and Bhakti Barve.
Okay.
So three pairs were there. So cut it short, I was selected for the role.
Wonderful. So at that time, how sure were they that Ben Kingsley is going to be playing Gandhi?
Not at the time of the screen test, but after the screen test, because I think they had some inkling, because though Ben and myself, we are taller than Kasturba and Gandhi, but the difference in the respective heights, it is the same. So maybe that, then Sir Richard in his autobiography, he mentioned that I was looking provincial and I wanted to, you know. And he praised Smita also. Smita is a wonderful actor.
Of course.
He said she was too beautiful to play Kasturba. I was more of this thing.
Tell us something about the preparation that Ben Kingsley had to do to just get into the skin of Gandhi. And I mean, my God, how well he managed to do that.
Ben and myself both, we had to learn charkha. Because learning charkha was the basic thing. Then I was trained in elocution. And Ben, I think he was getting training in yoga. Because he had to squat like... And I think his hip bone was... he had some accident before that. Then... We were supposed to research on our characters.
Okay.
So I was trying to find out books on Kasturba and didn't find it. I found just two books, Hamari Ba and Baur Bapu ki Sheetal Chhaya mein. So whenever Ben used to get some reference of Kasturba, he used to come and tell me, I got this reference for you.
What was the atmosphere on the sets like? Was it very different from the three Indian films that you had done? And
yes, I can say that. There was such a discipline on the set. If you have to have a utensil, then it is on the set.
Okay.
Mumbai, we were doing Phoenix Ashram scene. I suddenly saw a zebra. I said, zebra bhi laake yahan rakhe hain. So they had painted the donkeys and
left them. Okay.
So panim mein kuch aayega to kam se kam wo lagega.
Okay.
Not giraffes, but at least zebras.
Okay. The funeral scene of Mahatma Gandhi in the film, which became quite an iconic one because 300,000 people, 3 lakh people, it also entered the Guinness book. Was that planned that way at such scale?
See, that time the procession was planned. There were, I think, 12 cameras all over that route.
Sure.
One camera was on India Gate also. And I think Govind Nilani was operating that camera. So it was announced in papers and on radio and for the people to come.
Okay.
You know, whoever. But they said, don't wear the rangin clothes.
Okay.
I think it was on 30th January. The same day.
Yes. They shot the same day.
Everything was according to the picture.
How it actually happened. While filming, making the film, did you all have any idea that it'll go on to become such a milestone film in terms of both a commercial success and the critical acclaim that you got? I mean, 8 Academy Awards and $130 million at that time it made.
Yes. As I told you, the magnitude of the film, it came down on me by the end of the film, end of the shoot. So afterwards, when I saw the film, there was a private show for all the crew I was speechless. I said, "Rongte khade ho gaye the mere." I am telling you, in the West, India was known because of that film.
That's right. Yeah.
Otherwise, before that, tigers are roaming on the on the roads of India.
That's the perception. So, you know, the Gandhi that you saw, understood, imbibed during the making of such a cult film, and how the perception around Gandhiji has changed over the years, and now in our atmosphere, people have in this day and age, people have different views about what a Gandhian philosophy is. Some agree with it, some do not. How do you see these conflicting views, and have your views about Gandhiji changed over the years in any way?
Since Gandhiji was educated in England, since they were British, the principle of Gandhi of giving one cheek, when you're slapped on one cheek, giving another cheek, that was important. Gandhiji understood the psyche of British. Because Gandhiji knew Britishers' mind, that he can manipulate.
Right.
That's why he was successful. Basically, his teachings were like education. He was cleanliness, education, self-reliance. And that we need, now we need.
My last question, and this is the era of remakes in Bollywood. Yeah. But do you ever think a film like Gandhi, a biopic like Gandhi, could ever be remade in today's day and age by the present generation actors?
Yeah, maybe. I don't want to say ki they won't be able to. Mm-hmm. There are actors and they are good actors.
Can I risk asking you who you think could play Gandhi in today's day and age?
I don't know. Not Gandhi. But there are a few good actors. And if you have an eye, I think you can select one.
Well, thank you so much, Rohiniji, for taking out the time for this discussion. It was wonderful to have you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.